Thou shalt bind by thee many gathered hearts. Savitri tells Death that she feels one heart beating in all the hearts. One heart beating in all the hearts. One mind thinking in all the minds. He sees the cosmic spirit at work everywhere. Savitri sees the cosmic spirit working everywhere. Her heart lies with God, even in the night, even in the depth of darkness, the inconscient night. Even in that, her heart lies with God. That is what Savitri tells Death. But Death dismisses it. He questions all that. What are you talking? He questions all that and asks if indeed she is so strong to hold that one heart in her heart. He wants to show him what Savitri has in her. She must show him what she is, whether that really, that heart is there, whether that truth is there. He would like to see the truth in her. She may show him her force. Only when she would possess that thing, it may be possible for her to show her force to the gods, because the gods could not question it. Death's claim is that only one who is strong he would respect. He has no respect at all for the weak. His will is unchangeable. Nothing can dissuade him, force him to do something which is against his will. He has in his possession the soul of Satyavan, and Savitri cannot claim it back from him. She may have heart beating in the hearts of everybody. She may have a mind thinking in all the minds. She may have force which is applauded by the gods, but not for him. The soul of Satyavan is with him, and nothing can take it away from him. His will is unchangeable. He has done it, and that's all. Savitri wanted to look Death straight into the eyes of truth. Look into her heart and know who she is. That is what Savitri was saying. But Death bows his sovereign head in assent to give her what her Satyavan would give to her. Not the soul of Satyavan that he is going to give back to Savitri. Savitri is claiming that there is a truth in her heart, that the Divine Mother is seated in her heart. Maybe it is so, and to that extent, he may even grant her a boon. Boon not of giving her Satyavan back to her. But what Satyavan would have given to her? Satyavan would have given to her the joy of life. He would have given to her children. He would have given to her whatever she would have wished. Yes, if that is what you want, you don't need Satyavan for that. I will give to you. That is what death is telling to her. Bright nose and unwounded dawns, I will give you. Bright nose and unwounded dawns. Daughters and hero's sons, yes, I will give you. There shall be joy in her. There shall be joy in her house. In the company of her children, she'll be happy. Felicity shall surround her day all through. Love then shall bind her. Love our children. Love shall then bind her to all, to that. Love shall be gathered by her for many hearts. Love shall be by her many, in many gathered hearts. That is what death is promising to Savitri, but not Satyavan. Savitri resists death's offer. The gifts of death she does not want. By whatever offered mechanism, it might be possible for death to give her hero sons and bright daughters, daughters bright like the dawn. It might be possible for death to give to her, but Savitri says no, not by that way at all. Savitri resists death's gifts because earth cannot flower if she returns to earth without Satyavan. Her concern is not children for herself. Her concern is for the earth. If the earth has to flower, she must have her Satyavan back from him. Love shall bind by her many gathered hearts.